So if you want to get the current price of a stock into a spreadsheet, then Google Finance is a really good option. First, we need the ticker of a stock. So let's get one for Apple. In this case, Apple is capital AAPL. So what we do is just type that into any cell. That one's fine. And then in any other cell, we write equals Google Finance. You open the bracket and you click on that cell with the AAPL. You close the bracket and hit enter. And it gives us the value of 116.97. Just make sure that you check that that is the correct value that we're getting on, for example, Yahoo Finance. So that's cool. Let's put in another stock. This is TD. This is Toronto Dominion Bank. It's a bank in Canada. And see here, it's 4688. So when we just type this in, we do the same thing. Google Finance. And then we click on the cell, close the bracket. It gives us 4688 as expected. We can just give it a dollar sign there. Now, TD is on two different stock exchanges. It's on the New York Stock Exchange and it's also on the Toronto Stock Exchange, but it has different prices. In Toronto Stock Exchange, it's 61.54, and in the NYSE, it's 4688. So when we just typed in TD by itself, it gives us the New York Stock Exchange. If you want the Toronto Stock Exchange, sometimes what you have to do is actually indicate which exchange it is. So you would write TSE and then a colon. And then it's ticker TD. And you can drag this down. And basically, what that does is it just populates that cell. It just drags the formula. So we have Google Finance is equal to this thing, B5, what is in column B and row 5. When you hit enter, it gives us 6154. And that is correct. That is actually what we were expecting for the Toronto Stock Exchange. Notice on Yahoo Finance, it calls it TD.TO, but the format in Google Sheets is TSE colon and then the ticker. So yeah, that's a great reason to use Google Finance when you're building spreadsheets for your stock investment portfolio.